everybody. It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and we are
back in the garden again, where a gardener is always your friend. Through cold rain and sun, we're still having fun, because we're back in the garden again.
And there I see my one-eyed pirate, Captain Rick. I can never tell, is he winking at me or is he blinking?
Hey, matey. It's nice to be able to see again.
I'll bet it is. Until next week.
Yes.
That's why we haven't been around. That's why we haven't been back in the garden again. He's been recovering.
And well, joy is for me. I have to go through this all over again in 8 days.
Yes. And we would just like to have a special shout out to our dear friend, Scott Miller, who lives in Cleveland, who just went through major surgery. And he'll now have 6 to 8 weeks of watching us nonstop.
Won't that be a blast?
Thinking of you, Scott.
Yep.
And you too, Sarah.
Well, you know, I can't express how wonderful gardeners are. I mean, when you think about it, Scott and Sarah drove all the way from Ohio just to visit us and see our garden a couple years ago. And of course, we've been in touch ever since then. So, you know, such special people.
You guys are special friends, all you gardeners. There has just always been such support and love shown to us. We're very grateful.
Well, think of Dee and Kevin and Veda and all the other people that have come locally, I mean, to visit and spend time with us and go home with some goodies.
Yes.
So what are you going to be working on today?
Well, before this day is over, we are going to be digging up our garlic that we planted last October. It's almost past digging up time, but the weather has not cooperated. Either it's been way too hot or it's been too rainy. And now it's time to dig that up. And then we're going to be moving. We're going to let the squash vines take over where they were, because they are getting crazy.
Well, before you start, I think you need to look in the patch behind you, because I think you're going to find some surprises that I was able to actually see.
I'm almost afraid to look in here, because this is our zucchini patch. All right, now see this damage here? This is from the hail that we had on Saturday. So all these holes you see on these leaves is from the hail.
That hail ripped through. In fact, I'll probably include just a brief little snippet of the video that you took.
Well, and you're going to see on this zucchini that it too has hail damage.
Oh my, wow.
Not on the bottom.
Yep.
But on the top, and that's how we know it's hail damage and not insects.
Well, I think there's more in there. I feel badly that I couldn't get out here with you. I mean, I will say this, the most difficult thing I have right now is adjusting to the brightness of everything. I mean, it hurts. That's a good size one.
Yep, and that one was protected by the leaves, so yeah. That one's okay. More?
Yep,
there are
more in there.
At the door?
I'm going to go on this side of you here. Pull back some of these. Yep.
Well, that's another beauty.
I think there was another one way on the other side on the inside, but you're going to be going on there anyhow.
Right.
So.
Yep.
A little baby.
Nice size one.
Baby.
Yeah. Right here. A very little one, but I'll let that go.
Yep.
Okay, so you think we should start digging before the mosquitoes are going to eat us alive?
Okay, well, let me start loosening the soil for you, and then you can start pulling out the garlic.
Sounds good. Last night it rained, and we got half an inch of rain. No hail, thank goodness. So the soil is wonderful. It's loose. It's nice. I bet you're wondering how these look.
I am. Well, now, this is the double inoculated garlic.
Yeah.
If you haven't seen our first inoculation, I think.
Let me just take these
We
out.
Have it listed on our website.
Mm,
Well, those are kind of small. Not bad, though. But this end gets a lot more shade, too.
Yes, it does.
So maybe that had a factor.
And because our spring was so wet and so cold, these were not coming up as early as they usually come up. And they have, you know, had to wait longer because they took longer to grow. So instead of taking them out mid-July, here we are way into August already, and they are finally ready for us to harvest. So it's interesting. Weather does play a big part in how your garden grows.
Still not a bad size.
No, it's a perfect size.
Considering this started with one little clove.
All right, so what we're going to do now is we're just going to clean off some of this major soil here. And then these have to cure on the porch or in a dry place for about 3 weeks. And that will ensure that they are, this paper is forming. See, what you see now as kind of a translucent color, that will turn into a dry paper like you see on the ones in the store. And that's what protects it throughout the time that you're going to store it until the time you eat it.
And again, for those who maybe haven't seen us plant the garlic, this is
German striped
purple
hard-necked.
Stripe?
Right. This is a hard stem that goes all the way through to the roots. And as you peel these off, the stem is always there. The soft-necked garlic doesn't have that middle stem, and this part is pliable. So that's why you can see them woven together
braiding,
and hanging.
Braiding them,
right.
Yeah, and hanging. Well, I would say this is so past our normal time of digging them up. I mean, I don't ever remember being in August digging up garlic.
Nope. Nice garlic, though.
I know some of our viewers, I think, had mentioned that they've already dug up their garlic.
Yes.
About 3-4 weeks ago already.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yeah, and we could too if the weather had cooperated and,
if
you know,
I had
it
eyeballs.
Had grown, and if you had had two eyeballs that were working at the time.
Yeah. Well, my brain, it's interesting how eyes function. I mean, the brain is still trying to process. I keep missing a step every now and then.
That's because one eye is seeing so much better than the other.
I mean, I can wink at you and see
you
very
doing?
Clearly.
Are you winking or blinking?
Well, I don't know yet. I haven't decided. You'd probably be able to just pull them right out of the ground. That ground is so loose. Amazing.
Looking good.
Well, I think I'm going to put the camera down, help you, and we'll come back to filming as we're closer to the end. Because
till we get to the newer part.
Yeah,
because we have two different kinds in here. We have this German, striped German.
Purple stripe.
Right. And then we also have some porcelain, which we've never grown before, but we were told was very delicious. Although it doesn't store as well as these, so we may have to eat those first.
Oh, isn't that a shame?
And this is the end of the purple stripe. See, some of those are very nice size. Here, look at that monster.
Yeah.
Now, we'll be saving the largest ones, and those are the ones that we'll plant for next year.
Will they last that long?
We'll plant those in October.
Oh, that's right. See how I'm out of rhythm here. You know, it's been far, far too long. So now this is the porcelain garden.
This is the
garlic
porcelain,
over here,
right?
Right.
Now, supposedly,
I think you have a sticker back there, too.
This is more...
Or a plant marker, I should say.
Let's see what we have here. Okay. So we have the German extra hardy, and then we have the porcelain garlic. Unless that's the German extra hardy porcelain garlic. Maybe that's what it's called.
That, I think so, yeah.
We've never planted this kind before, so this is new to us. Oh yeah, it's a different shape. And
yeah.
No purple stripes.
Yeah.
And we bought these from a garlic farmer from at the farmer's market last fall or last summer. And I'm just taking some of this soil off of here, and I'm trying not to disturb the actual bulb itself or take any of the outer coating off. I guess I wouldn't have had to be so careful about where I planted these. I didn't know if I'd recognize the two differences or not.
Very identifiable.
Yep. Well, we're very pleased with the crop this year. Well, I think we were expecting baseball size ones. We're happy with what we got.
And we don't know if it was the weather. We don't know if garlic has a maximum growth. I mean, it's not going to be that fake elephant ear garlic that they call elephant ear garlic.
Right. Yep.
That's not really garlic, is it?
No, it's more onion than garlic.
Okay.
Same family, but more onion. Smells great.
It sure does.
Makes me hungry right now for a Caesar salad.
Well, considering I think we only planted, maybe 100 cloves or so this year?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Which is more than enough.
Oh, more than enough.
But again, we start with that German extra
hardy porcelain
garlic,
yep,
which we experimented for the first time. But the one that we've
usually
mostly have grown is the German purple stripe hardneck. So what else did you find on the way out of the garden?
You saw a couple of the zucchini we picked, and then we found some more zucchini. We found, this is a delicata. It doesn't have its stripes yet. It usually has green stripes, and you can see, but because of the size of it, we decided that we'd pick it because you don't want delicatas to get too long and big.
That is like eating butter.
Yes. This is the 700-year-old seeds that they found in Green Bay when they were doing an excavation.
A burial site. They found seeds in a ceramic container.
Now, they weren't those seeds, but they were propagated from those seeds. This one is definitely not done yet, but it came undone while I was moving the vines around. Again, you can see where
the hail damage
is on there, and it's had a rough life so far. Then there's this one. We didn't plant any green squash, so we're thinking that the bees have been cross-pollinating, and I think it's a pollination between a zucchini and a spaghetti squash. Rick thinks it's between a zucchini and a delicata.
No, I think it's the spaghetti squash and the delicata.
Ah, okay.
I think it's a combination of that.
Well, we'll see.
Well, I'm glad to see the 700-year-old seed squash plant actually did something, because
yes,
I think I only got 5 seeds, and
they
it was like $10.
Yeah, they were either $1 or $2 per seed. So it was very interesting. I think I kept one package, and if we can get a full-sized squash later on in the season. They are a winter squash, so you know they're going to take longer to develop.
Well, it's a giant squash,
yes,
and I guess it can be up to 15, 20 pounds?
The picture we saw looked
like a massive
baby that he was carrying.
It's like at least 3 foot long.
If we can get a big one that has mature seeds, then we can use those seeds next year, because those are heirloom seeds.
Well, I'd say today I'm happy I can even see the little red button blinking here, because I don't think I would have seen it a couple of days ago.
You're doing great. You can now see things that I can't see. So that's
look at that.
That's good.
You have one wrinkle. I never saw that wrinkle before.
Don't even talk about my wrinkles.
Oh.
With your new camera, you can see all my wrinkles. I was kind of hiding them on your old camera. Many of our viewers have asked how the ginkgos are doing. Remember, we are trying to propagate ginkgos from our big ginkgo tree and also from seeds from our neighbor's ginkgo tree. So this was the first one that we dug up off of the major big father tree.
Well, this was actually growing off the base of it.
Yes. And it has one, two, three, four stems coming up. And this one never had any recovery time. It was happy from the moment.
Had a lot of new growth, too.
Yeah, from the moment we took it out, all of this is new. All this darker is new. This is the one that we started from seeds from our neighbor's female tree. We have no idea. Are these male? Are they female? We won't know until 20 years from now. So somebody will find out.
But those two are doing wonderful.
They are doing great. Actually, there were three seeds. I planted four. Three came up, but the one was always kind of iffy. So that one's kind of eliminated itself. But these two guys are doing fantastically. This was another little offshoot of the main tree. And it, too, is doing great.
New growth.
Very happy with it. Now, this was one, the main... Actually, this was the biggest one.
That was off the other side of the tree
right.
that this one came from.
Yes.
But it was really tall. I mean, this was already close to 2 foot tall.
Yes.
So that was quite a shock.
It didn't have as nice a root system as this one. It already, it was more difficult to dig this one up. We had to really work at it to get it to come out of the ground and detach from the parent plant. We are very fearful for this one for a while, and you can see that the tips of it definitely have suffered, but
the stalk
is still good, and the offshoot of that stalk is good, and they're all
there's
nice and
green.
There's
a new growth under that leaf. I see that.
Yep.
Yeah.
See?
So it is growing.
I should
and
probably
there's another one there.
Yep. I should probably trim this part off, do you think?
Well, go ahead. I mean, we're talking about possibly bonsaiing these anyhow, so.
Okay.
And probably the same with a really tall one there.
And this one.
Yep.
Because there is another
yep, new growth.
Possible growth right there. And that one doesn't, well, does that look good or not? Yeah, that looks good. I'm just going to take it off right there. And maybe this leaf. Yeah. And that way, you know, it's not trying to keep those things alive as well as trying to make new roots. We've been very pleased with these. We hope they do well. In the winter, what we're going to do is sink these pots into the fenced-in garden. And we will just leave them outside all winter under the snow. This is what they do with bonsai trees. They leave them in the climate that they're native to. So they will be underground pot-wise, but the tops will be sticking up and will be in the elements and in the snow all winter long. And hopefully, come spring, they'll be lovely.
Well, that's where you plant me in the fall.
Well, yes, and don't you turn out lovely in
yes,
the spring?
Yes, I know.
Well, we hope you enjoyed our little song, and we hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give us a thumbs up. We'd appreciate it. Again, another shout out to Scott and Sarah. Do well. Get back in that garden. And also, if you have comments or questions, we would love to hear from you. If you'd like to become part of our garden family, there's that little tiny subscribe button. It's seems to be getting tinier all the time.
Yes, it is.
But we'd appreciate that too. Thank you so much for watching.
Can I wink at you now?
Okay, let's see it. Decide which eye you're going
to
wink from.
Well,
your good
I have
eye
to,
or your not so good
I
eye?
I have to practice because in a couple of days I have the other one done now.
Yes, you will.
Then I'll be winking at you twice as much.
Then you'll be blinking for sure.
Don't call me Blinky or Shirley.
Bye-bye.
Connect with us on YouTube.